a question that I get frequently is questions about the implementation of nutritional ketosis. And there are a lot of different strategies that can be used to put someone into a state of nutritional or therapeutic ketosis. And that can include the classic ketogenic diet, which some people think is kind of archaic or maybe even draconian, which is up to 90% of the calories from fat and a very limited amount of carbohydrates, like 3%. And probably what's, from the practical perspective, there's a limitation of protein, too, that makes it kind of hard to follow. The modified ketogenic diet, or the modified Atkins diet, is more liberal in protein, up to 20 to 25%. And the medium-chain triglyceride diet, in the upper right-hand corner, is a little more liberal in carbohydrates because the medium-chain triglycerides are ketogenic fats and can help one get into and sustain ketosis. So I think there's a wide variety of ways, you know, and diets that people can choose, not only the macronutrient ratios, but the types of foods, which is not really talked about. From a clinical perspective, they don't really talk about the foods in the ketogenic diet, but I think that's a whole nother area of research, the types of fats that are in the diet, and even the types of proteins and carbohydrates.